JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for November the 4th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar was found lower against most of the other major currencies this morning. It gained only versus the yen and Aussie, while it was found nearly unchanged against the euro. The greenback lost ground versus the kiwi, the pound, the Swiss franc, and the Canadian dollar. The performance in the FX sphere does not paint a clear picture with regards to the broader market sentiment. Therefore, in order to get an idea of investors' morale, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Now here, European indices were mixed, but Wall Street edged north with all three of its main averages hitting fresh record highs again. Appetite remained supported during the Asian session today as well. Now, yesterday, the main event on the agenda was the FOMC decision, with the committee announcing the beginning of its quantitative easing tapering process, as was widely anticipated, at a pace of $15 billion per month. They committed on another $15 billion tapering for December, but they added that they stay prepared to adjust the pace beyond December if warranted. In the statement accompanying the decision, they said that inflation is elevated, largely reflecting factors that are expected. I'm highlighting the part expected to be transitory. Remember, the previous part was inflation is elevated, largely reflecting transitory factors. They were adamant on the fact that those factors will be transitory. Now they said those factors are expected to be transitory. So this means that, okay, they kept the transitory language, but they are not so adamant on that view now. And with regards to interest rates, Powell said that it's not the time to raise them and added that they can be patient on that front. Now, the US dollar slid initially, perhaps due to the fact that officials maintained the transitory language in the statement, as well as due to Powell's patient approach. However, we don't believe that this could be the start of a trend reversal in the US dollar. The fact that they softened the language on inflation, as well as the fact that Powell did leave the door open for interest rates to start rising at some point next year, may keep the slide short-lived. Even market participants may share that view. According to the Fed Fund futures, they brought forth their high expectations after the FOMC announcement, after the outcome. They brought it from September 2022, ahead of the meeting, to August 2022. Now, in our view, any future remarks or hints suggesting that interest rates could indeed start rising after the tapering is over may allow traders to buy more dollars. For now, we prefer to exploit any USD gains, mostly against the Japanese yen. Although the greenback slid on the Fed decision, it was found higher against its Japanese counterpart this morning, and this may be due to the Bank of Japan's policy to keep a lid on its government bond yields. In our view, US Treasury yields may stay supported in the aftermath of the Fed decision, and thus, due to yield differentials, dollar yen could keep drifting north. Now, today, the central bank torch will be passed to the Bank of England. Back in September, the bank kept all its policy settings unchanged, but in the statement accompanying the decision, it appeared very confident on interest rate increases. Officials noted that some developments have strengthened the case of some modest tightening over the forecast period, and added that this should come in the form of a rate hike, even if that becomes appropriate before the quantitative easing end. Now, recent data showed that the inflation in the UK slowed more than anticipated in September, but both the headline and core rates stayed well above the Bank of England's objective of 2%. This, combined with the fact that Governor Andrew Bailey and MPC member Michael Sanders have expressed willingness to push the hike button very soon, prompted market participants to assign an 80% chance of a 15 basis points hike to take place at this gathering today. At least according to the UK overnight index swaps forward yield curve. Therefore, a 15 basis points hike by itself, if happens, is unlikely to move the pound much. We believe that if indeed the bank lifts rates, market participants will quickly turn their attention to the statement, the meeting minutes, the bank's updated economic projections. Let's not forget that this is a super Thursday for the Bank of England. We get the inflation report, but also on the voting over a hike. So, if the decision is a close call on to increase interest rates, and the language and projections point to a slower rate path than the overnight index swaps curve suggests, then the pound could pull back. So it will be one of those cases where you have a setback in the currency despite the central bank raising interest rates. There is also a chance that due to the recent supply shortages in the UK that appear to have left their mark on the economy, officials refrain from hitting the hike button now and perhaps wait until next month, a decision that could result in a stronger sell-off in the pound. Remember that the Bank of England appeared confident on interest rate increases. Some officials were hawkish that they want to raise rates very soon, but due to the latest bottlenecks in the UK, they could wait until December. No one has committed to do that at this meeting. Now, with all that in mind, we believe that the risks surrounding the pound's reaction are tilted to the downside. On the one hand, we have if they hike rates and they show slower rate path, the pound could slide. If they don't hike, the pound could slide. It could slide more. For the pound to rebound and strengthen, the Bank of England may have to appear more optimistic than the current market pricing suggests. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides the Bank of England decision, we get the final market services and composite PMIs for October from the Eurozone, as well as the UK's construction PMI for the same month. Later in the day, from the US, as every Thursday, we have the initial jobless claims for last week. Now, with regards to the energy market, we have the OPEC Plus group gathering, but the official outcome may not become public until tomorrow. Although the group is under pressure, is under pressure from the US to increase supply, several members appear unwilling to do so, with one of the latest headlines pointing to Algeria saying that output should not exceed the current agreement of 400,000 barrels per day because of market uncertainty and risks. Therefore, the base case scenario is for no change, which is unlikely to affect oil prices much. For oil prices to slide notably, the group may need to surprise the markets by announcing an increase in its quotas. There is also chatter that they may double production in November but keep it unchanged in December. However, we don't see this as a material change, and we would expect the effect, if any, on oil prices to be temporary. As for the speakers, besides Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey, who will present the inflation report after his bank's decision, we will get to hear from ECB President Christine Lagarde and ECB Executive Board members Frank Elderson and Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT just fair and direct.